Hi guys, this is Omer from MMOHunt.com, and I'm their first impressions gameplay video for Black Prophecy, a 3D sci-fi themed MMORPG published by Gamigo. Now I'll spend about 10 to 15 minutes running around, checking this game out, make some comments. If you guys want to play Black Prophecy, or just learn more about it, do check out the full review on the link below. So let's get started right now, guys. The game itself went into open beta in the US in early June 2011. The game was in open beta in Europe a bit earlier, which is why I'm doing the gameplay video just now here in June. So let's go ahead and log in over here, and hopefully I know my account name and password, and let us log in. I suspect I will get a bit of fraps lag because the game does have actually really high-end graphics, especially for a free-to-play MMORPG over here. We're going to play in the one world right now. I'm not sure why they call it a world, considering it's a sci-fi themed game, and it's supposed to be a universe. And you can see in the background the nice graphics over there, and we're going to play on the US open beta server over there and click select. Got a little flag over there, low population right now because the game just launched. Gotta cut some slack over there. And the game was developed by Reactor Games, I believe, and that's Reactor with like 2 K's, a weird spelling of that. So let's create our character right now. And there are, I think, 2 factions in the game, but we'll see right now. Wow, you can see the detail on your character over here. Though I'm not sure how much we're actually going to see our character once we actually jump into the game. I'm sure we'll be flying around and shipping all that good stuff. So my base Wow, I can see my expanded face over here. I can like alter my forehead, my eyes, all that good stuff. My chin, you know what? I'm gonna get a massive chin. The bigger the chin, the better. And I'm sure there's a nice boob slider over here if you're playing a female character. And my jaw shape. Aw yeah, look at that, funky. Let's go out over there. I will see my base in it. You can be female. Is there a boob slider? There better be. In the future, we better have, you know, let's see. I can make myself Caucasian, African, Asian, all that good stuff. Way over there, expanded. And overbite. No, what is this? In the future, you can't even adjust your chest size. What's up with this? Is this a lame future? But you know what? I want to just randomize it. There's a randomize button over here. I can go with the preset for now. I'm going to go run with the preset, but you can see the depth of the game's character customization. This guy is like, this guy's awesome. He's got a scar in the face, but he's kind of happy about it. Look at this guy. He's like smiling. He's good to go. We're going to run with this guy. And you can change your age as well. Wow. It actually ages. Wow. It's actually really cool. Just look at the aging process over there. And it looks, you know, really interesting. This guy is way too happy to be that. I don't know. He's a little freaky. My name will be Remote with 2 E's over there. And let's click create. But I am pleased with what I see in the character creation screen. I feel like so many MMORPGs don't do enough on character creation. I do feel like a lot of sci-fi MMORPGs and MMOs, for some odd reason, usually have more in-depth appearance customization options than fantasy-themed games. I guess when a company makes a fantasy-themed game, they feel like they can get away with having a really lame, you know, appearance customization. But I guess in these sci-fi games, it's a bigger deal. And you can see a lot of junk floating around space over there. That was a loading screen, apparently. That junk flying over there. We got Uriel, Anada, They say it was against God. Will the Sabidur was settled by humans? So the game is trying to set up its story over here. I'm going to skip this for now. But there is some voice acting in the background too, which is always nice. I mean, the game looks like it has high production value. And the game's graphics do look nice as well. But we'll see what it actually looks like when we actually jump into the game over here. I will click escape for now. I will watch that again later. Whoa, we got a logo or something. What is this? We got a Stellarvox Veritas over there. And we are in a Stellarox Lawina 5 over here. So intro does seem pretty cool right now. I do want to skip this just so I can see some actual gameplay and just jump into the game right now. So what, we are arrival right now. Where am I right? Whoa, I'm like on a turret right now, it looks like, of encyclopedia entry over there. Alright, defense officer. I'm in a simple tutorial right now, so I'm gonna go shoot those guys over there. Now I am lagging a tad bit again because I'm using Fraps Report over here, but let's go kill that guy over there. And your actual shots are a bit delayed, much like if you were actually shooting a turret. Whoa, what's getting all funky over there? Oh, synchronizing. In these tutorials, we'll explain the game's most important controls as opposed to the least important controls. So aiming is actually a tad bit difficult. This tutorial screen keeps popping up. You know what? I can figure out left mouse button shoots. Come on, I can figure that out. I destroyed Pathfinder Novice, go me. But there's actual delay between your actual shots and where they, you know, it's not like when you shoot, your bullets get there instantly. So that's being a bit realistic. You kind of have to aim in front of your enemies. Though, are all these guys bad dudes or are they good dudes? Is that guy an enemy over there? You know what? I'm just going to kill everybody that goes in front of me for now. And I destroyed Pathfinder Novice, go me. And the music in the background does seem very spacey and sci-fi-ish over there. Not sure why they're all flying around randomly, but I have to kill a few more of these dudes. And damn it, they're coming after me. Not sure which guys are mine, but it's Commander Noah destroyed this guy over here right now, too. But the beginning mission over here is a tutorial. I'm pretty sure I can't really lose this. So we'll take my sweet time and blast all these guys right now. But graphically speaking, the game does look nice, and the music is very fast-paced as well. So appearance-wise, I am definitely impressed. But we'll see what it looks like when I'm actually flying on my own ship rather than trying to friendly fire my tutorial ship over here. But look how big these ships look. It looks really cool. And I think aside from maybe EVE Online, there really aren't that many sci-fi themed MMORPGs out there. There is a Battlestar Galactica Online, which I feel is one of the only other free-to-play games. But that's browser-based and it uses the Unity engine, so the graphics are a tad bit limited by the browser. But even though it's on a browser, it does have pretty nice graphics. But we got, Sapiens over there, his weapon systems are down. So I'm going to kill you over there. And so far I'm really sucking at aiming over here. Oh, here we go, we're synchronizing over there. We got a weapon heat. So as our weapon heats up, we can't keep spamming it apparently. I guess that's trying to be realistic as well. Though I suspect in the future they should have been able to like cool better or something. I don't know. And my targeting system makes it easy to keep track of. Click T over there. T repeatedly. What does T do over there? What am I doing with T over here? Click T again, and I'm moving automatically with my over there. Numerous shields. What is? I'm trying to click T, but there's nothing. It just makes my turret spin pretty randomly, I think. What is T doing, guys? I'll click T again. T is not helping me, guys. It says click T to auto-target, but it's not auto-targeting. And my durability is on the right side over here. And I have to kill a few more dudes right now. Defend the colony ships. Gotta kill all these dudes over there. And I can't see my turret while I shoot up here, but we got this guy over here, my neighbor over here. This AI over here is spazzing out. He's doing a pretty cool job over there. And I'm gonna aim. That's my albino rookie. Is that my team? I think he is. Otherwise, I wouldn't be able to see his stats over there. So let's keep looking around. What's left for us to kill? These dudes over there. So I probably did them. This little tutorial over here probably would be finished a lot earlier if I actually finished this earlier. But I am taking my sweet time at killing these guys right now. Let's kill a few of these. They're actually losing HP though. My teammates are losing their HP. So I gotta actually help them out over here before they actually die. So this is actually one of the game's missions. It's a tutorial mission right now, I suspect. But the game is a progression. It's supposed to be through missions, these quests you can do in the game. And you can do those missions with up to 10 players apparently. And let's keep killing these guys right now. Not sure how many factions are in the game. I know EVE Online had 4 factions. That guy's going way out of my range over there. He's so far away. I can't even kill that guy. My teammates are kind of killing each other. My teammates are doing a pretty good job cleaning them up though over there. Keep shooting these guys. Hopefully can I skip this right now? Nope, I still got to stick around through here right now. And I feel like I'm missing because I am getting a tad bit of lag on fraps. But keep killing these guys right now. They have little plasma shields over there. Click T again. What does T do? It says T auto-targets, but doesn't really... Oh, I gotta kill that guy over there. Albino rookie. So T tells me where those nearby targets are. So let's go kill that guy over here. I was aiming at like the wrong guys. At least I think I was. I killed those guys with the HP bars, apparently. Which I did not know. Is he going down yet? Nope, he's still kind of dodging me over there. Come on. Oh, I gotta kill... Am I supposed to kill that guy? I think I do, but again, I'm not 100% sure. But we'll go try right now. That guy, he's going to go down. He's going to go down. And it's really hard to hit this guy. I'm missing pretty poor. I'm doing pretty awful right now. And his HP is going down a bit slowly, but he's going to go down eventually. Oh my gosh, the guys are dying over there. There we go, finally got him. I kept missing though. It's really hard to hit them when they're that far away. And we'll click T again. I got to kill that guy over there, and hopefully that's the last one. But the guys over there are kind of talking to me randomly. I'm not really listening to them. But this last guy, and hopefully when he dies, it should be over here. He is down to, he's still got plenty of HP. And so far, I am just missing Gomi. Yes, he is dead. Gomi, finally. Intercept the torpedoes. Defend the colony ships. My first, 5 minutes, I was shooting at the completely wrong targets. Gomi. But you can see your little interface over here, too. My concentration, guys, is only 160 right now. And, what are we going next? My shields are taking a hit. Click T over there. I gotta go up there. There's, 4 of the guys over there. I kind of want to fly my own ship right now, but I'm still using my own little turret over here for this tutorial mission. Afterwards, I'm sure I'll get my own ship. And did they just suicide into me? Those jerks. Click T over there again, and it's going to bring me towards this guy. I got to kill that guy right now. He is really far away, though. It's going to be hard to kill him. And there we go. And I think as long as you get our crosshair on him, it should be a bit easier to hit. So let's go put my crosshair over there. He's so far away. Can I even hit him? Is he out of my range? He's 1,000 range away from me right now. Not sure what 1,000 what? 1,000 like feet, 1,000 yards, meters, all that good stuff. And he's way too far. I can't even hit that guy. But he's dead. Go me. I just got him. We got to kill this guy down over here, too. Last time I was shooting my own allies like a boss. Let's go shoot these guys over here. Aiming, it takes a little while to get used to. My ship is getting missiled as well. But I'm pretty sure there's a structure in a way that we can't lose. Though, I kind of want to skip this part for now. I might start re-recording after I finish this part. Because so far, I've been shooting these ships for a while. Mainly because I've been sucking it up so far. I am impressed by the game's graphics, though. This guy is taking forever to die. There you go. He's almost dead. Come on. Why is he not dead yet? Yeah, nope. Almost dead. Come on. Come on. And yes, he's dead. Well, a few more to go again. Man, there are a lot of these little dudes over here. I feel like this is a bit dragged out right now. I can keep holding down my shoot button, though. Can I right-click? Nope, I can't right-click for, like, missiles or something. But right now, I'm just holding down my shoot button. I don't think I can really overheat on this mission. Though later on, when you're flying your own ship, I'm sure your stuff can actually overheat. So far, am I just really bad at aiming, or is this just taking forever? Like, what more do you want me to do? I'm clicking on it. There's a little crosshair, and it's on that dude. And it's not doing anything. He's still not dead yet. And once he flies, there you go. He's out of my range, I guess. But when they get close, it's actually a lot easier. I got intercepted torpedoes still, apparently. But more albino rookies flying around. Where are these torpedoes for me to intercept anyway? Are there special torpedoes coming towards me? Or are they just hitting me and doing absolutely nothing? I don't know yet. But guys, I'm going to stop recording for now. And once I get past this part, I'm going to start re-recording. It just finished over there. How awesome is that? So we got a little cutscene over here going on. Try to make it look all epic. I guess this part is like story-driven too. But I'm going to click... there we go. Commander Noah is... Noah to the gunners. Give my wingman cover. You know what? I'm going to click escape and see what happens next. So yes, Arrival Ianos. I just finished this part. Go me. Took long enough though. I totally sucked it up early on. And am I done over here yet? Nope. We got to defend the colony ship some more apparently. I'm going to start recording this again once this section is over. So I'll pause for now. And actually just start re-recording in a bit. Alright guys, I just finished that section of the game. It's actually a really nice little tutorial in the game. I can move with WSAD right now. I do feel like I'm still in a tutorial. Once I stopped recording, the fraps lag completely went away, and it was actually a lot nicer. But graphically, the game does look awesome, and it's actually kind of a cool intro. I mean, right when you jump into the game, it throws you right to the middle of the action to get a good feel for the game. And, the combat does take a little while to get used to, because you do have to aim a little bit delayed, but it works out pretty nicely, and it's supposed to be a bit realistic. We're supposed to move with WSAND, but these guys are talking to me over here. And being it's a sci-fi themed game, you got this robot-looking dude, and the orbital station is talking to me. How cool is that? Admire the Nimbus, apparently. And graphically, guys, I really like the game's graphics. I'm actually a sucker for sci-fi games, but, well, sci-fi genre in general. I am a fan of Star Trek. I've watched Battlestar Galactica. I think I watched all the Star Treks, though I haven't finished Voyager. I could never get around to finishing that one. I'm not sure why, but I do plan to watch it eventually. We got these guys flying around over here, more NPCs, and we got the most modern ship of its generation. Apparently, guys, right now, I still can't move, but you do see the game's actual, like, ship combat right now and ship graphics. These are actual gameplay graphics you're seeing right now, and for a free-to-play game, it does look really awesome. And, of course, free-to-play games are getting better and better. There's no doubt over there. And there were a few cutscenes I skipped as well. And I watched one of the last cutscenes, and the cutscenes are high quality, definitely high production value. And I'm still can't move around right now. I got a list of these dudes. It did say WSAD shoot. No, there we go. I can move around right now. I click space and bam, I can move right now. So you can see the movement over there, my speed over there on the left side over there. I'm going 270. 270 what again? I don't know. But I can't really shoot right now. I have to escort the Dione. What is the Dione? Where's the escort thing I gotta shoot? And you see at the top right, you can see your map. And being it's a space themed game, but it's a 3D map apparently. You can see a little circular good stuff on the top right in the spire, which is where I am right now. Yeah, suicide that guy. How cool would that be? I'm gonna crash into your engines and you're gonna die. He's my colony ship right now. So apparently we're trying to colonize somewhere, it looks like. And we got a big welcome thingamajig over there. And for a space, if you're a fan of sci-fi games, you really don't have too many options amongst free-to-play MMORPGs and MMOs. So you definitely do want to give Black Prophecy a try. If anything, because it's one of the only sci-fi themed games. Plus, it's actually a really high quality game in terms of graphics and production value. Though I haven't really jumped into the gameplay too much, it did seem pretty interesting and pretty fast-paced. One of the main differences between this and EVE Online is supposed to be that the EVE Online is more of a tactical game. I haven't really played EVE Online too much. I have watched several of my friends play it, and when they play that game like uber zoomed out, and it's all like you just click on your target and use mash hotkeys. Here, you're actually aiming your individual attack, so it's more action-oriented. So apparently my ships over here are getting fought over here, and now we got a battle coming up, so I guess we got ambushed by somebody or something. But I'm gonna skip this cutscene as well. I feel like the actual in-game graphics are better than the cutscenes, because the cutscenes seem a bit blurry to me. I'm not sure why. I mean, they did seem like really blurred out. But when you're actually flying around, the graphics, I think, look a lot nicer. So you know what? These cutscenes are kind of lame when the in-game graphics are better. So we got some rocks floating around, and something happened apparently. My ship is drifting away. I'm gonna click escape again, and we'll see where I find myself. I am in the Spire Ianos over there. And I start shooting. I want to shoot some stuff on my ship now. So my OSSY is checking my ships over here. My cockpit is undamaged. Engine check. I am good to go, guys. My ship is good to go. So something happened apparently, but I survived something. You can see my inventory over here. Let's see. I want some interface stuff right now. Nope, I got more help tabs over here. I don't need to look at that. My ship stats are kind of reading off of here. Guys, I'm in Nimbus 37/2 apparently. And interface, I guess you use these little squares over here. I got a repair drone over there. I know EVE Online had repair drones as well. And the actual equipment in the game is supposed to be a bit like EVE Online. There's a ton of variety for like individual modules you can equip on your ship, you know, shield stuff, and there's supposed to be so much variety over there. That's really where the game's customization is supposed to come in. I got some scrap drones over there. Mass mode, and I can enter mass mode by pressing space. Let's go ahead and do that. Once this tutorial thing goes away, the game wants to make sure when you jump into the game, you know what's going on, which is why you have all these scripted events going on and these tutorials right now. I mean, the place that I'm at right now, what you're seeing right now, is not the persistent aspect of the game. We're not actually seeing other players right now. These are all NPCs. But it makes sense that a game like this does have a lot of scripted events and a lot of tutorial stuff, because the game does, I guess the learning curve is definitely a bit steeper. So yep, left click over here does shoot. I want to kill these scrap drones. I want to slow down. Where are these guys? Are they behind that rock? Let's go around that rock and go shoot them. And I'm still really impressed by the game's graphics. I mean, it is remarkably fluid. And my ship can go sideways. That's kind of like unrealistic, but awesome nonetheless. I mean, if you click D, you can move with, you know, you can move sideways. That's actually really cool. So where are these guys right now? I gotta find another dude to kill. Maybe over there. We got a little. There you go. That's my arrow. Let's go aim. These guys keep hiding behind rocks. What jerks? Let's go cut this guy off. That scrap drone. He's being a jerk and hiding behind that rock. What an a-hole. Let's go around and kill. Is he really just walking around? Let's go this way and catch him. Get him off guard. Oh, no, I don't want to bump into that. What is this guy doing? Is he really just running around this rock trying to dodge me? If he is, he's such an asshole. Let's go get him. Yes, there he is. I gotta go kill that guy right now. And so far, I managed to crash into the rock once. And then a-hole guys, he ran around the rock again. The game is trying to teach you, I guess, some of the movement stuff. So I guess you gotta, you know, get used to chasing enemies. Yes, we're gonna kill that guy. Yes, we finally got him. He kept running around that rock like a total jerk. I get the second guy. He's like over here somewhere. You can see on the top right where he is in position, in relation to my position. And he's somewhere over there. Let's go get that guy. The ship I'm using right now, I guess, is the starting ship. But I'm sure there's a different classification of ships, like battleships and stuff too, because I did see a battleship in the game's tutorial, and the battleship looked awesome. It was huge. And my weapon systems are online. No, of course they're online. I just killed two ships with my newbie ship over here. And calculations complete. What calculations? I'm not sure, guys, but the calculations are complete. So let's go with Chillax over here until it tells him where to go next. I suspect my tutorial should be over soon. I want to see my for character over there. Nope, close that out for now. And then the help menu coming up. And you can see my character stats. This guy is way too happy. He's just really happy over there. My time played right now is apparently 0 minutes. I have only joined 0 teams, go me. So it does keep track of your deaths, your aliens killed, PvP missions, and PvE missions. That's kind of cool, there's PvP missions as well. You can do missions with up to 10 other players at once, which is kind of cool. I mean, really cooperative efforts over there. And can you customize your character again? Yeah, so it looks like if you don't like the way your character looks, you just click customize and bam, you can change them around. I'm not sure if this is only for the tutorial, but you can maybe only change certain stuff like your hairstyle. So you can't just like totally change yourself whenever you want. That'd be too boss. You can see my skills over here, and I got no skills right now, apparently. Points remaining 0, so you get points by actually leveling up. Whereas EVE Online had an interesting like a skill learning system where you would automatically learn skills while logged off, which is a really odd progression system if you ask me, because a lot of people just, you know, set their skills and just log off the game because you gain skills while you're logged off. I don't think that's the case over here. It's a more standard skill system kind of over here. We see my tactics tab over there, which I guess is more of a skill tree kind of system. What are these active tactics right now? I can change these later on. I have one tactic point going me, not going to spend that because I'm going to screw myself up. And we got medals, which I guess are, I can move this around, go me. We got achievements, which of course you guys know what achievements are. I found the clan, but I didn't. Too bad, I got no achievements right now. So if I purchase a clan station, I get an achievement. So you can have your own station if you're a clan, guys. And there are a bunch of these achievements, which I guess give you rewards. So yeah, wow, that's a lot of aliens killed. My rankings right now. My rankings should be 1337. That'd be awesome, but I got no rankings. Close that out for now, though. And where are we going next? Repair drones will automatically repair my ship. Use F5 to launch them. Let's go ahead and do that. Why not? F5 for my drones. And there are no drones coming out. F5 is totally not doing anything. We got Commander Noah from my tutorial over here. Oberon 5, are you okay? So again, there's a lot of these scripted events going on, but so far my first impressions are that I am a bit impressed by the game. What the actual gameplay is like when you're playing with other players is still up in the air because I haven't actually done any cooperative missions yet, but the game does look very promising. If you're into sci-fi themed games and you have a high-end PC, definitely want to give Black Prophecy a try. I'm playing the game on a higher resolution, but the game, as you know, I'm playing a 1920x1080, but of course I'm sure the game supports a lower resolution as well. But anyway, guys, I don't want to drag this video on too long. I will make another video for the game once I'm more established in Black Prophecy to show you some of the stuff later on, but for now I am going to call it. And it does look really cool. I think it's worth trying. If you guys do want to play Black Prophecy or just learn more about it, do check out the full review on mmhot.com on the link below. Anyway, guys, later.